Charles Woodson, if I had told you, let's say back in the day, let's say when you were first drafted by the Raiders, that you would be, and just hear me out here, that you would be going into the Pro Football Hall of Fame, announced the night before Tom Brady plays in his 10th career Super Bowl at the age of 43, you would have said what? You would have said what to me, Charles?
First, I probably would have said we're in 2021.
Yep.
Wow. Yeah, I couldn't imagine that either of us, you know, would have still been playing in 2021.
Mm-hmm.
So I would have said, you know, what? That's a hell of a dream that you have there, Rich. You mm-hmm. know, whatever was going to happen would have happened years ago and not in 2021.
Right.
But this is, you know, for me, I sit back and I've watched, you know, Brady the last, you know, couple of weeks, you know, playing in the playoffs, and it's just amazing to me, man. And I know everybody's talked about it, but the fact that this man's been to 10 Super Bowls, half of his career, you know, myself playing in the NFL for a long time, knowing how hard it is to get to, just to get to the playoffs, let alone to make it to the Super Bowl, to get there 10 times, man, is unbelievable. The Hall of Fame part of your question, I would say, yeah, I could see that. I could see me being introduced. But Tom Brady still playing and in his 10th Super Bowl? Absolutely not.
It's truly unheard of. And I'm sure, you know, again, you have all sorts of emotions. What was it like watching the NFC Championship game with one of your former teams that you hold so near and dear to you with the Packers and Cheesehead Nation needing so much – needing to win that one so much? I mean, and I use the word need purposefully here because of how long it has been since you went out in that Super Bowl with an injury that eventually was the winner anyway, because you said as long as Obama was going to be rooting for the Bears, we need to show up in his house, right. Which was one of the greatest lines in the history of locker room celebrations. What was it like for you to watch that game with Brady versus Rodgers and the Packers, Charles?
Well, man, I was pulling for, you know, pulling for the Packers, man, heavily, man, because, you know, earlier in the season, you know, kind of, you know, once they got past the midway point, I thought that, man, the Packers looked like the team to beat to me in the run to the Super Bowl. And so I really felt like they had started to click at the right time. And I thought that this was going to be the year that, you know, Aaron Rodgers would, you know, lead his team to a second Super Bowl. And then, you know, as the, you know, the playoffs, you know, roll around and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers started to play better, I thought to myself, you know, once they drew them, you know, to go to the championship game, I said, man, this is probably the least of the matchups that the Packers won. And, you know, the reason being is because, you know, Tampa Bay handled them pretty handily, you know, earlier in that season. And the way they beat them was with defense and being able to run the ball. And you see the way that this game played out. That's exactly kind of what happened. You know, Tampa Bay came in, beat them with defense, jumped on them early. And then, you know, the run by Fournette, you know, running the ball and that touchdown he ran was incredible. But I still thought that, you know, during the course of that game that A-Rod would be able to, you know, put the team on his back, so to speak. They came up with some big second half turnovers that Green Bay wasn't really able to capitalize on, which I think, you know, killed them as far as the outcome of the game. But I really thought this was going to be the year, you know, that they got back to the Super Bowl, man. So I was hurting, man, you know, especially with the last series of the game for the Packers and, you know, fourth down, deciding to go for the field goal and not having a chance for A-Rod to score that touchdown. And it was just hard, man. It was hard to watch, you know, for the Packers and for Aaron Rodgers and all the guys on that team, Coach LaFleur. But then again, you know what I mean? I do have an old teammate on the team, the other side of the ball, you know, Brady, and it's like I'm happy for him because, man, this dude is legendary, and he's doing something nobody's ever done before, taking a team to the Super Bowl in their own, you know, hometown. Like, who better to do it, you know, than Tom Brady? So, you know, definitely torn, you know, about the outcome. More so for the Packers because I thought this was going to be their year, but definitely happy for Tom and his team, man, for being able to get there.
Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.